This is part 5 in our short-term business decisions series, and here we're going to be discussing outsourcing and process further decisions. So first we'll talk about outsourcing and things that management need to think about when deciding whether to outsource. How do our variable costs compare to outsourcing costs? Remember, fixed costs typically you can't get rid of. In some instances, you can. So variable costs are what we really focus on. Variable costs are created when we produce a product. So if we outsource, those variable costs are likely to disappear. Are the fixed costs really avoidable if we outsource? So for example, rent on a manufacturing building. Well, we may not need the manufacturing building anymore if we outsource. So that would be an avoidable fixed cost that we could get rid of if we outsourced. What could be done with freed capacity? So we have to think about our opportunity cost. So what are we foregoing by not outsourcing? So for example, if we own the building, if we outsourced, we could rent the building out. So by not outsourcing, we are foregoing the rent that we could be earning on our building. That's an opportunity cost. So let's look at the decision rules of whether we should outsource or not. If the incremental cost of making a product exceed the incremental cost of outsourcing, then we should outsource. That means it costs more for us to make it than for us to buy it somewhere else. If the incremental cost of making the product are less than the incremental cost of outsourcing or buying it from somewhere else, then we do not outsource. Let's also look at the decision whether we should sell a product as it is or process it further. Just as with all these other decisions we're looking at, there are things management must consider. For example, how much revenue is generated if we sell the product as it is? And compare that with how much revenue is generated if we sell the product after processing it further. Keep in mind, typically if you process a product further, there's going to be additional cost involved. And how much will it cost to process the product further? Now let's look at the decision rule. So should we sell as is or process further? If the extra revenue from processing further exceeds the extra cost of processing further, then we should go through with processing the product further. If the extra revenue from processing further is less than the extra cost involved in processing further, then we should sell as is and do not process the product further. Let's look at an example with gasoline. So we see here that we have $125,000 in sunk cost for producing 50,000 gallons of regular gasoline. We have two choices. We can sell as is or we can process further. If we sell as is, we will have $190,000 in sales revenue. If we process further, we'll have $200,000 in sales revenue. There's no additional cost if we sell as is. Looking straight on here, well, we should process further because we're getting $10,000 more in revenue. But remember what we said earlier. There's typically a cost involved when you process a product further. Just as in this case, there is a cost involved. With sell as is, there is not a cost involved. However, with processing further, we would need to pay $7,500 in additional cost to process the product further. So now we have to take in consideration that there's $10,000 more in revenues if we process further, but there's also $7,500 in additional cost of processing further. However, since $10,000 is higher than $7,500, then we should process the product further.